Hello, hello. Welcome to episode 14 of Neverwinter Night's Adventure Series number 8, Prophet Chapter 1, By the Will of Kings and Mortals. We're ready to head to the mountains. But to get there, we have to go through deep forests. We have a special stone that will transport us back to with Sylvain, if needed. Moves the quiet path. I'm curious if there isn't something more to this. Oh, what do we have here? Magical stone emits a comforting glow. Larian gasps. Where's my dire bear going? Whose house is this? Druid's home. Rithian, we've heard of you.
I bid you greetings.
Greetings, my name is Karina Kovaleski. Greetings, Karina Kovaleski. I am called Rithian Letnarin. What can I do for you? What do you do here? I watch over the forest and take care of the Nalir. What is a Nalir? It is neither tree nor stone. It is alive like the forest, but eternal like the earth. Is it that glowing stone outside of your home? Yes, that is the Nalir. What does it do? Do? Yes, what powers does it have? It does not in itself have any powers. It is a symbol, not a tool. And what is it a symbol of? It is a symbol of the bond between the earth and the living things that grow upon the earth. Its presence is a question, and my care for it is the response. I don't understand. Can you explain that, please? We are all part of a story, Karina Kovaleski. Each of us is a statement in the great entwined tale that is spoken by the world. The Nalir is a question posed, a question about the relationship between sentient beings and the nature that surrounds them. My care for it is an answer to that question. And what is my part in this story? I do not know, Karina Kovaleski. That is something you yourself must discover. See. Can you tell me the way to the Ophiorian River? Yes, but may I ask why you seek the river? The sage Evanorn has told me that it will lead me to the peaks of the Dalthorim Mountains. And what is it you seek there? I seek a man by the name of Uther Palindros. Lord Evanorn believes that he had built the tower there many years ago. I do not know of this man, but I do not follow events beyond the borders of this forest. And can you tell me the way of the river? You must head back westward along the road that brought you here. When you come to where the road turns north to the city of Bristlevane, turn south. You will come across a pair of great oaks that frame a narrow place leading further south. South? Points to a place on your map. That path shall lead you to the Ophiorian River. My thanks. You are welcome. She looks at you with a curious gaze. What is it? Have I not seen your face before, madam? I do not think so. I don't see where we could have met. Of course, I am sure that you are right. Where did you think you had seen me before? Perhaps in a dream? A dream? Why do you think that? Sometimes I have dreams that are visions of the future. I see things that have yet come to pass. Perhaps you have had such dreams as well. Oh no, my dreams are not like that. They are never about the past or the future. They are always about the present. And what do you see in your dreams? I see the forest. I share my mind with the trees and the wildlife and see through their eyes. My dreams are the dreams of the forest. And you have not seen me in those dreams, then? No, I must be mistaken. Perhaps you just have a familiar-looking face. Perhaps you are right. Thank you for your help. May serenity wrap her warmth around you.
I bid you greetings.
Okay, I must go now. So I went the wrong way? Thank you. like stuck. Not good. Not good.
Is there something you wish?
Off this tree. Thank you. Excuse me. Not sure if I'm going the right way. Circus River Crossing, barricade, orc guards, gate. Travel south from Ristlevane into the deep forest. There I must find the Druid Rithian and summit with the Elfjord, and to follow the river eastward along its southern bank. It will lead me to the peaks of the Dalthorim Mountains. Perhaps I wasn't meant to come back this far. Instead of going to Ristlevane, turn south. That's Ristlevane. Yeah, so then it must be in this area. Tell me the way again. I'm lost.
I bid you greetings.
You must head back westward along the road that brought you here. When you come to where the road turns north to the city of Ritzelvane turns south, you will come across a pair of great oaks that frame a narrow path leading further south. That path shall lead you to the Ophiorian River. So when you go, follow the road that you came, and it says to go north to the city of Ritzelvane, turn south, and a pair of great oaks will frame a narrow path to the Ophiorian River. Right here, we have to go south. Is this it? Twin Oaks? No. Somehow I feel I'm missing it, and it isn't actually this way. This is too far back to the Linlithorn Forest. South. don't understand where to go. Talk to her again.
I bid you greeting.
She has some items. Let's head back westward along the road that brought you here. When you come to where the road turns north to the city of Wrestlevane turns south, you'll come across a pair of great oaks that frame a narrow path leading further south, points to a place on your map. It's in this map. My bad. Okay, so go back westward. And when it says to go north, a pair of twin oaks will frame a narrow path south. This looks like the spot. No. It would help if we had a source of light. Alright, I guess it's westward. The bear was waiting in the water, so I guess we can ford the river here. The current is strong, but you can keep your balance. Oh, you want beef? In there, dire bear.
Taste of my wrath.
Ooh, greatsword plus one. Ring of regen. And amethyst. Ring of regen. I don't think I can use it. I have a ring of intelligence plus two. And we need the intelligence. Hi, Shaman. The Orc Berserker? Nothing. Let's cure your serious wounds. Pretty good. Mushrooms for us. Falls of Crintalore. That's, we were told that these. Yes, what is it, Larian? I've been thinking about what Lord Evanorn told us, as have I, Larian. He seems quite sure that this man Uther Palindras was an honorable and good man. But how can he be sure? Lord Evanorn is a very good judge of people, Karini, and this man was a good friend to him. Perhaps, but then it seems someone wants people to believe that the Prophet King was responsible. Why would someone wish this? I do not know, but prophets have often been the object of persecution. Often they are feared and hated for the things that they see. So So you think Uther Palindres was framed for this atrocity? Why? He's been dead for hundreds of years. Perhaps not. Perhaps he has survived somehow. And one of his enemies has survived as well? Maybe. We cannot speculate without learning more of the facts. Yes, we must find this tower that the Prophet King had built. Come on. Now that is what I call a waterfall. Indeed. I don't know if that's the way to go, or back east. Or back west, I should say. Out this way. I'm sure there are many secrets hidden in these mountains. That mortals have not found. The orcs aren't very good scouts, even though they're elite. Grizzly bear. Summon right there, didn't you? Let's go up the mountain then. Not elite by our standards, is what I should say. So many spots can be hidden amongst the rocks.
This
carving over there. Carving? Lord. Oh, the finger. The person. The head and the finger. What is that? The Ophiorian River tumbles from the Dalthorim Mountains into the forest of Linlitharn over a great waterfall called Crin Talor. The name is thought to come from an obscure orcish dialect in which it means hands of the hated. It probably refers to a great carving in the cliffside in the shape of a pointing hand. The origins or meaning of this carving are unknown, as is the reason behind the name, since whatever ancient tribe of orcs had thus named it has died long ago. The elven priest Anandel told me of a great elven exodus which took place more than 15,000 years ago. The elven homelands of Eril Sanath, far to the north, had grown old and began to die. With them, the elven civilization would have died as well, were it not for the determination of a great queen named Demisra Ristilvane. She convinced her people to leave their ancient homes and travel south across the mountains. After a long journey, they arrived at the forest now known as Linlitharn, where they built a new civilization. I wonder what mysteries were left behind in the ancient elven lands. Somewhere in the cold reaches of the far north, the ruins of those cities must still exist, and among them, the treasures and knowledge of a great civilization await those with the taste of adventure. Ristilvane is home to one of the major clans of the Linlitharn Elves, aptly named the Ristilvane Clan. The city is also the seat of the Senrad, a council house where the elders of each of the elven houses meet to discuss matters of state. However, since almost all matters among elves are handled locally, there is rarely occasion to call such a meeting. The last time the Senrad was called was during a harsh winter 112 years ago, when a white dragon from the Dalthorim preyed upon creatures of the eastern forest. The dragon eventually retreated into the mountains, perhaps driven off by elven arrows, or perhaps simply by the coming spring. And that dragon may still exist in these mountains. Do we continue traveling up from here? Dalthorim Mountains, sometimes called the Shatter Peaks, are a large mountain range that marks the eastern border of the Elven Kingdom of Lindlotharn. Due to their rugged nature, they remain largely unexplored despite being fairly close to several populated regions. As there is mystery surrounding the mountains, so there are numerous legends. Those include stories of giants who inhabit the cold peaks, living in great ice towers that reach into the clouds. There are legends of great treasure buried in ancient forgotten cities guarded by legions of undead. And of course, there are legends of dragons which rule the rooftop of the world. Few, if any, know the truth among these tales, for even few return from the highest reaches of the Shattered Peaks. Something moves in the depths of this cave. Enemy my opponent. Alright, you're getting a fireball. Throw it. Thank you. drop mushrooms. Pleasure in slaying my conants. Or tangle vines which ruin my frame rate. For no reason. I guess it got us some remove disease mushrooms, but seems a bit odd. Search. My conants aren't the only thing living in these mountains. Goblins across the river, I spotted them. Oh. Oh, I fell. That's the point of this cave. Don't fall. Sorry, guys. I rushed in right to my doom. Kind of weird you all fell down with me. I guess you came to check if I was okay. Let's go get him, man. This way. Nothing. So we must fight the goblins. Don't fall this time. Alright, so in the next episode, well, I can continue this. The hell of shame and remorse. What is this? Don't scare me like that. Where to go up? Come on. shaman's giving us problems. Can't hit him for some reason. Some flippers on him. Punching them. Where's my sword and shield? Where's my sword? Guys. Larian's dead, but where's my sword and shield? Missing. Did it fall down in the river? Where did my sword and shield go? Yep, I fell down here. I must have lost my sword and shield. There it is. Weaving blade and torch, but where's my shield? Oh, there's my shield. Okay, I had a torch on. Ooh, almost lost my sword. I know this episode's going over time. I'm gonna clear out the goblins and then we'll call it a day. Scary, losing my sword and my... Oh, my torch. Losing my sword. What is that? Inflict moderate wounds? And this is cure moderate wounds? We should rest. I'm gonna save it here. This is successful episode 14. Goblins next. Thanks for watching. Much love, peace, joy. See you next time.